Ciao friends! We have been waiting this day for almost 2 years, but we finally have calculation groups for Power BI Desktop. Calculation groups are a useful technique to modify the behavior of existing measures. And this could be very useful for problems like applying time intelligence calculations to existing measures. In this example, I have a report without calculation groups. And if I want to display the sales amount, the value of, sales amount in the previous year, for the same period in the previous year, the difference between the current period and the same period in the previous year, in this column, and the same difference as a percentage, I need 4 measures. Here you see sales amount and the other 3 variations of this measure. Now, I need to write this code for sales amount, but what happens if I want to apply the same transformations to another measure, like margin? At this point, in order to complete this report, I should create other variations of the margin measure. And I had to create other 3 measures with other 3 DAX expressions. Almost identical for most of the part, but this is a time-consuming operation that also pollutes my list of measures with a lot of names. With a calculation group, I have another option. Let's take a look at the final result I can obtain using calculation groups. In this model, I have only 4 measures. And you see that I have only sales amount. I don't have all the variations of sales amount. Nevertheless, my report shows the value of the sales amount in a particular quarter or month, the value of the same period in the previous year, the difference between these periods, current period and the same period in the previous year, and the difference as a percentage. Now, these transformations of the measure sales amount are obtained through a calculation group that in the model appears like a table. In this case, I call this calculation group time intelligence, and this shows just a column that I named formula. In formula, I have 4 calculation items, and a calculation item contains a DAX expression that transforms the value of the existing measure. In this case, my 4 calculation items are current, PY, YOY, and YOY as a percentage. So, this is exactly the same report I had before for the sales amount. What happens, what I need to do if I want to obtain the same result for the margin? Well, I just have to drag and drop my formula column here from the time intelligence calculation group to the report in the columns of my matrix. And now the same transformations are applied to the margin measure. You can do this thanks to a tool called Tabular Editor. As you see, I have a menu, a ribbon here, external tools, that has an icon, Tabular Editor. In order to get this icon, you have to download and install on your PC Tabular Editor. Tabular Editor registers itself as an external tool for Power BI, and when you open this tool, you can access to the tabular model, which is the model behind the Power BI desktop model. You see that there is a warning. You could create damages. You could break your model if you don't know what to do. But actually, when you just add a calculation group, this is a supported feature. When you look at the documentation of Tabular Editor, you will discover that not all of the operations you can apply over this model are supported by Power BI Desktop, even though this will change and improve over time. Now, once you are in Tabular Editor, you see the list of the tables, the measure that you have in each table, and the columns you have in each table. But the calculation group is just like another table. However, within the calculation group, you see a list of calculation items, each one with the corresponding DAX expression that defines the transformation that you want to apply. In order to create new calculation groups, of course, you can start here and create a new calculation group. But what is more important, you have to study what are calculation groups in DAX and what is the right syntax and the right technique you can use in your calculation items. But once you get the knowledge, once you understand how to use these techniques, you can also control other things that are not possible with the regular measures. For example, in this report, you see that I have some calculation group that is controlling the currency exchange rates and in supplying the currency conversion for different currencies, each one displayed with a proper display format. So you can dynamically change the format string of each measure. This and much more is possible thanks to the calculation groups and thanks to Tabular Editor integrated with Power BI Desktop. So download the Tabular Editor tool, study the calculation groups. You can find a lot of content in our website, sqlbi.com. We also have an entire chapter about calculation groups in our book, The Definitive Guide to DAX. And of course, we also have a section in our Mastering DAX video course. So download Tabular Editor, install it, study calculation groups, enjoy DAX.